My Hubketta is ready for orders.
The battle is about to commence. Kawagisi and Tofu, playing as Soviets in the north. Oops. Versus Tumi? I have no idea. That's an umlaut on the U. I don't know how you would pronounce this in German. Tumi. Is it a hard E or is it just like Tum, like it would be in English? Or neither of those things. I don't know. And YG now. Which obviously stands for YOLO Gangstas.
Enemy is alerted to our presence. Prepare for counter-strike.
Now. In all caps. Which... I don't know what I'm trying to say. They're apparently also an arranged team because they're in like a clan or something together. On the left side, there's a Kubel wagon and some Sturm Pios and stuff. On the right side, there are conscripts and more Sturm Pios. Ooh, one of them just got sniped for making it into the... Oh wait, those aren't Sturm Pios, those are just Pio Pios. Either way, one of them goes down before making it into the building. Looks like he actually skipped past this strategic point, wanted to get control of that house as early as possible. This house is only so useful, has pretty limited windows. But it can help you kind of hold a position for a while. Thanks to this sandbag fighting position, these conscripts are going to take minimal damage engaging those pioneers. Until forced to the other side, of course, by these grenadiers over here. The Maxim has arrived and it's going to lay quite a bit of damage on the pioneers in there as well. It looks like things, however, on the left side going quite well. Kubelwagen has been completely repaired.
Our brave infantry is dying.
Continues to prevent the Soviets from advancing across the river, which means they will not be able to take control of the German fuel. As far as commanders, we have counterattack already chosen. Counterattack is, in my opinion, probably the most devastatingly powerful Soviet commander on this map. You almost never see Crossing in the Woods not turn into a slugfest, so you pretty much can't go wrong with the B4. You can build it in your base and just blast your opponent for the entire game. That being said, now that close air support has become extremely popular, and there are other pretty scary German dive bomb doctrines available to Oster as well, you need to be a little bit careful about throwing the B4 on the field if there's an Oster flare on the other side of the river. That being said, if you're aware of what his loadout is, you may not even be so afraid. We do see one Stuka Bomb Strike commander available here. So if he picks that, he will be hard countering that counterattack tactics choice. And, the other options are elite troops, which I really don't think is a very good choice on any map that can very likely result in a slugfest the way Crossing in the Woods can. As I mentioned in my last cast, and Mechanized Assault, which is always a very solid pick, so I wouldn't be too surprised to see that either. YG now has Breakthrough, Special Operations, and Scavenge. I'm not really sure what I think the best one would be out of those. Breakthrough is... I mean, the Augtiger's okay on this map, I suppose. Scavenge, I don't know, it's alright. Spec Ops could be alright. I think any of those could be a good choice. I've seen Oversoldat STG has used a pretty good effect on this map before. Although it's a long-range map, transitioning to the STGs later on when you need to start making big pushes and increase your DPS can be helpful once they're already like vet 3 or 4 or something. Then you can vet them up quite easily on this map early on, utilizing their long range. Yes, I am it's a replay. I don't know why I said that I'm spectating a live game. It is a replay. I almost never do live 2v2s, because they're kind of hard to find matchups that I like, so I'll just stick to requests. I mean, it's probably not that hard to find a good 2v2. It's mostly just that it's so easy to find a good 1v1. There's almost always a 1v1 matchup that I'm tempted to watch. So much for that conscript squad and the house they were inside of. Flamethrower will retreat. He did prompt his opponent to throw a grenade though, which, as we know, very much delays Panzer Shreks. He has one currently. The second one's going to be a while. A little while. That being said, they have a lot of munitions coming in because the Soviet on the left is just getting shut down by one Kuva wagon. It doesn't seem to be any way for him to break through his containment, and probably because he purchased a sniper against OKW, I mean, it's good, but a Kuba wagon fears not the sniper.
Sniper now available for duty.
And it looks like we could see some dangerously aggressive truck placement over here. Looks like they're feeling very confident, getting so aggressive as to try to take even cut off right outside the Allied base. Looks like his surge of confidence is waning. Decided that maybe that wouldn't work out so well. And he's going to throw up his tier 4 structure here. This placement is absolutely terrible. I cannot stress enough how bad this placement is. This is truly, this may be the worst tier 4 placement I could ever even imagine on this map. This may be the easiest position to assault I've ever seen, and extraordinarily difficult to defend with red cover completely surrounding it. I definitely do not see this ending well. It's kind of interesting that he made this decision, considering how effectively he's beaten back his opposition so far. Hopefully the Soviets will be able to capitalize on this mistake. They've seen it now, they should easily be able to get vision of it, utilizing the sniper and destroy it utilizing a field gun. And as long as they can effectively screen away any counterattack, that tier 4 should be dead within the next 5 minutes. Ouch. That was a neat little twirl.
IL-2 available for reconnaissance flight.
It's the rear!
Thanks, physics. Well, fortunately, he's going to at least get a few units out of this thing. He's producing a Lux now. He'll probably have enough manpower to throw out a squad of Obers as well. Fortunately for him, no pressure has yet been applied to his absurdly aggressive tech structure. There is a tier 2 up here, and another one just got constructed there, so they both have access to field guns, and they need to start throwing them out and applying pressure as soon as possible. If they wait until they have some form of call-in, or tanks or something to put pressure on it, it may be a little bit late. And 9 minutes in the game, you should definitely start thinking about fielding a way to destroy this. You don't want it to lock down a hugely aggressive area of the map like this for free. You really need to punish your opponent for that placement as quickly and effectively as you can with a coordinated push, hopefully with your teammate, if necessary. Not looking very good for the Allies here. It is really not good. They're just getting smashed so bad. They can barely hold on to their half of the river, let alone make offensive pushes onto the left side. And when the Axis hold this territory, it's a bad sign. 10 minutes into the game, the Allies need to secure a lead. A Especially if the Soviets don't play into the late game, which they could be. Counterattack certainly forms. I mean, it's kind of a mid and late game commander, since the B4 sort of puts a timer on the axis of death. The more it fires, the closer they are to just losing everything they have. But, Tofu, not so sure what we're gonna see. Guard Motor is the best late game commander he has available to him. Soviet Shock Army would give them yet more artillery, which, while not bad, is not that amazingly great either. And anti-infantry tactics would be terrible. I certainly hope he doesn't choose that.
Mission accomplished.
Because while the KV-8 is nice, it can only do so much.
Combat unit ready.
I can't believe that Lux is going to get away with main gun destroyed. That is amazing. Apparently nothing could get in range. And there is a field gun over here. Yet this remains unpunished. Like, how do you not destroy this? Just shoot at it.
Squad back to full strength.
Preferably before all the Obersoldaten and stuff arrive.
Ready yourself,
or not. I guess it's a little late for that now. Rifle grenade does negligible damage. They're nicely spread and in green cover.
Target captured. No enemy contact.
The long range warfare continues again, not really anything happening anywhere. Just kind of probing, pushing, trying to win the manpower war. Looks like the Axis managed to take control of the right side of fuel for quite a while, and they have the Allies triple capped right now. Soviet snipers are trying to bleed the Axis where they can. Bunker went up over here, pointed at this angle of approach. Not really anything defending this particular avenue of attack, and it looks like the right side victory point may fall here, but a lot of pressure is making its way towards the Soviet cutoff. There is a field gun here to defend. Ooh, that looks just got main gun destroyed again, but it will go down at range from another following up field gun shot. It had to hit a mine and get shot three times, but its reign of terror has come to a fiery end, for Mother Russia just got activated for some reason. I'm not sure what that's about, but okay. And it apparently did not get applied to these shock troops because they weren't on the battlefield yet. Interesting. Interesting nuance to that ability, I wasn't actually aware of that. But apparently it will not get applied to units that haven't been fielded yet. Even though it lasts like a million years. Well, that push just got shut down hard. Thanks to the power from Mother Russia and snipers, I guess. Squads are desperately retreating. Looks like they're both going to get away by a hair. And again, no pressure over here. This got built 6 minutes ago. What are they waiting for? They have a tank now. Lots of pressure over here on the right side. It's so misplaced. What does this accomplish? You're just stealing a machine gun and decapping a strategic point for a little while. That's nice and everything, but killing this is so much more important. It's such a high-value target, and they've barely even scratched it. Oh, finally! Sniper fires a flare to give vision, field guns firing from a million miles away, a position that's very difficult for the Axis to punish. I can't believe they didn't do this, like, 5 minutes ago. Nice play. Obersoldaten now forced to respond. If they had done this before there were two squads of Obersoldaten, they probably would have been able to destroy that with ease. Now, it's going to be a little bit more difficult. But still probably doable because of that absurdly aggressive placement. As long as they can force retreats. and open windows of time during which they can safely attack.
Incoming fire! Light tank ready to deploy.
Apparently, YG now has gotten himself a second Luke's. Kind of an interesting decision, since he was only about 5 fuel away from being able to afford a Panther if he didn't do that. I guess he decides that he needs more anti-infantry firepower in the form of a light tank, and then he needs anti-tank, which is somewhat questionable. I don't think... Oh yeah, they do. They know that Kawagizi is counterattack tactics, which means they need Panthers. The Panther is a very effective counter to counterattack, like everything. There's nothing in this commander it doesn't counter. It can aggressively push and try to destroy a B4. It's very effective against a KV-1. It doesn't get bothered by shock troops, so the Panther is a very powerful unit against counterattack tactics. You don't need to worry about being swarmed by 2-3-4-85s or getting blasted from range by IS-2-152s or having to contend with IS-2s. None of those things are a serious threat, which makes the Panther a much safer decision than it would normally be, and even against those commanders it's very good. So I really think you should try to get one of those out as soon as you can. But apparently he just purchased... Oh no, he didn't. Never mind, I was looking at the wrong thing. So yeah, he's got a Luke's. He's gonna be able to get a Panther soon. Might be going for the Command Panther, actually, since he just went Spec Ops. But I guess we'll see. And he is purchasing himself the Infrared Package. I think it's a little bit early for that. They're not that high vet yet, so it's a little bit dangerous to charge across the river and get into close range with a squad that doesn't have that much veterancy, but... I guess we'll see what happens. Panzer IV has been fielded here in all its ugly-ass glory, now that it's the stupid J model instead of the other letter.
The enemy is attempting to steal our sector! Panzer IV is ready for battle. We are losing a sector!
He's actually getting SCGs on both of these squads. Dangerous! A dangerous decision. He's investing a lot into those to make them actually a little bit vulnerable as they attempt to approach. Even at maximum range, they still do extremely good damage, honestly. It's not that much of a reduction. But, I definitely think that it would have been worthwhile to just wait a little bit longer on that upgrade. That being said, he's not really being bled that badly on advance. The Soviets are sorely lacking in direct fire. The best manpower bleed tools they seem to have are these two snipers, which are doing quite nicely, 18 and 19 kills each. They could be doing better, but they could be doing worse. KV-1 doing about as well as it normally does. Pretty much just useful for soaking up damage, not that great at dishing it out. But it will be very good at providing vision, spearheading the assault on this tier 4 structure, which may finally go down here if those field guns would move. Bet he's wishing he had a B4 right now. His infantry are so clumped. I think one of the most crazy things you can do as Axis his blob while fighting a KV-1, because you know that there's a B-4 on its way. And it's pretty dangerous.
Back on promotion! Snipers under attack!
We are ready for anything.
Watch out!
Yes, comrade?
On the right side, it looks like Panzer Force is struggling to make progress. He's waiting for some of his forces to recuperate and make another push over here for the right side. He's got two Panzer IVs, three Grenadier squads, and his mortar. Without any machine guns, he may struggle a little bit against Soviet infantry. He's also operating on a 400 manpower deficit after throwing up these two fuel caches, but at this point in the game, that investment becomes less and less of a factor. And a pack is making its way over there as well to help deal with this T-34. The Soviets actually have one fuel cache of their own as well. And a Command Panther has been fielded here from YG now. Oh no. Well, so much for those two squads. B4 makes his very first shot counting already. He has 10 kills. 10
okay,
kills!
That's the last one.
He's only fired at one time. Panzer IVs looking for an opportunity here on the right side. Kind of just dancing back and forth though. He knows that there's a lot of field guns and defenses over there, and he certainly doesn't want to hit any mines either. He has purchased himself a mine sweeper to try and give his tanks assistance should they try and make an aggressive push up the right side, but they need to be very careful about it. So even if they do get across the river without sustaining too much damage, it's going to take a while for these tanks to destroy all threats over there. And it looks like he's getting harassed quite badly even at range. Looks like those field guns want to move up and get a little bit aggressive here.
Well done. We have forced the enemy
one Panzer IV coming dangerously close to being destroyed. There it goes, at maximum range it will get sniped.
The enemy has destroyed a Panzer.
Aggressive field gun push. Wasn't quite paying attention and his tank goes down. Meanwhile, of course, Stern Pioneers harassing an AT gun over here on the cutoff. Do manage to decrew it, but will be forced to retreat by those conscripts. Grenadiers moving up to support here. Soviets getting very aggressive and pushing across the river with team weapons. But a stolen MG-42 will suppress the Grenadiers that move to respond. Push seems to be going quite well. B4 fires one more time. Did it get anything? I don't think so. That shot looked like it was pretty off target. Oh, I was just about to check its kill count, but apparently it's dead. Okay. So yes, Toomey has found, chosen the Jaeger armor commander to directly hard counter the B4. He correctly waited to adapt to what his opponent was doing. Ooh, Overshot Squad just got wiped right there. And since the B4 is basically a non-issue as long as he maintains the munitions for the stupid dive bomb, with recon, obviously, that's going to put the Soviets in a pretty awkward position. They were definitely depending on that B4 to put a serious dent in their opponent's infantry. That being said, that mission has largely been accomplished since both Obersoldaten squads have been wiped, which means that infantry and team weapons are once again free to make a push across up the left side without having to worry about getting killed at range by Overs. They should be able to destroy this, and the window of opportunity that they just opened will close if they don't capitalize on that soon. They really need to, Oh, that was close. They really need to mobilize forces to destroy this now rather than later. If they can get that off the field before more Obersoldaten are completed, they will have secured themselves a huge advantage. And although that may mean diverting forces away from the right side, the gains from that could be huge. It would be unlikely that the Oberkommando West player could hold this area without any elite infantry. But they're in production now, and it doesn't look like they're sending anything. They're just continuing to dig in and fight over here on the right side for no concrete objective other than this munitions point, which is just... it's just nowhere near as important as destroying this structure. I can't believe that it's still alive. Hugely aggressive push by this nukes doesn't look like it's about to end very well. Main gun destroyed and killed before it could take out either of those snipers. That one will be reinforced and healed just fine. And that will be the second nukes to be destroyed without really accomplishing much of anything.
Grenadiers back to full strength.
Unit ready.
Soviet mortar fire getting pretty intense. A second one has been fielded to supplement the damage. And I think that squad of grenadiers just got wiped. There was an elephant on the field, the other attractive feature to the Jaeger armor doctrine. And it's kind of map dependent on crossing. It can definitely do quite nicely. Anything that tries to cross the river at this area will definitely be punished hard. Recon run looking for targets, I guess, over here on the left, or just actually doing recon since he no longer has a V4, and I guess he doesn't intend to purchase another one. And he probably couldn't safely do so considering the Axis had 52 munitions coming in. You can try and keep building B4s if you can lock down your opponent's munitions, since obviously that does not appear to be a possibility. There's not much they can do. The Axis from just dive bombing it every time they build one. A lot of pressure being applied to this structure. It will probably be destroyed soon. This could be their last chance to defend. Nope, there it goes. Gets taken out. Not really anything he could do to save that, like I said before. They had a window of opportunity to destroy that before any Obersoldaten hit the field. They were a little late. One squad made it out, but not the end of the world, I guess. If they can wipe that squad somehow, they will definitely have a significant infantry advantage over the Oberkommando West, especially considering he's operating now on only three squads of Volksgrenadiers. So this is basically the next high priority target that needs to be wiped out. Meanwhile, on the right side, obviously the elephants is going to be a serious concern. Soviets don't have much of a way to deal with that right now. The T-34-85s obviously will be able to swarm it if we can mass enough of them. He probably should have completed this structure if he wanted access to the Katyusha. And the snipers continue to be a huge problem. Dealing massive bleed over here on the left side, and every time they shoot an Obersoldaten, that's 50 manpower right down the drain. Combined, they have almost 70 kills. KV-1's doing a good job of soaking up that P-51 Panther's damage, and the AT guns fire on it. In the meantime, Sniper's trying to deal with infantry threats, but the Soviet player cannot seem to get any territory under his control on the right side, whereas Tofu is doing a much better job of getting map back under his control. And it's so important to get those munitions, because if they can control the munitions, they can control the frequency of Stuka dive bombs and possibly get another B4 up, and that's something that they really, really need. Tier 4 has been constructed, getting himself an SU-85 to try to apply a little more pressure to the Command Panther. After that, possibly a Katyusha. Katyusha's a lot more mobile than a B4, so you don't have to worry about it being dive bombed, but it's obviously a lot less effective against priority targets like the elephants.
We must defend our headquarters.
Ouch, high explosive barrage inflicting heavy casualties. OKW has purchased a Stuka, however, to try to deal with these team weapons and possibly snipers. Very nice opening barrage will wipe out both of the team weapons. The snipers are fine, but that was a very powerful opening and entrance for that unit. Already has 10 kills on the very first barrage, and if he can keep barrages of that strength up, that's going to be a serious problem. Big push across the river here by T-34s, but it doesn't go too well. One of them gets taken out pretty quickly by the elephant. Two elephants, excuse me. Okay. And the second T-34 will pull back to safety. This T-34 has been, or this field gun has been recruited. Firing on the Command Panther, which is trying to blitz to safety. It should be able to do so. The final SU-85 shot misses, and it gets outside the arc of fire of those AT weapons. And we'll await repairs here by the Mechanized Regiment HQ while the Stuka gets ready to move up for its next barrage. Victory points falling to the Allies now, grabbing control of the center with the stolen MG-42. And there's a very light presence here on the right side, but it looks like the Oster have moved most of their units to try to deal with the center and left. Brave Grenadier trying to capture the center. Just couldn't make it happen. These elephants are a very serious threat to the T-34s. Any armor that shows itself will just get shredded by those if they manage to get a line on it. And the Stuka is going to continue to be a very serious problem for the Soviets as well. If they don't field some kind of solution to get that thing destroyed, and they're just gonna get bled to death, and their team weapons are only gonna last so long. And the Soviets have a lot of perfectly viable solutions to the Stuka. In fact, a vetted Katyusha can actually kill one with a concentrated barrage. Nothing gets wiped. The point is decapped, however, by the Stuka bomb strike. And they will need to reinforce those team weapons.
Small arms fire!
just activated for Mother Russia. I... Again, to be totally honest, I'm not sure why. I don't know what he's... why he's doing that. I guess just to try and win this engagement. I don't think it gives any particularly meaningful bonus to snipers other than that they move really fast. Stuka pops a flamethrower, wiping out the squad. Not much of anything else though. Field gun's still kicking. Looks like he's trying to finally make a push and get some fuel and territory here on the left side back under control. But it looks like it's gonna get shut down. That shock troop squad's about to get killed by the one squad of ogres that he could not prevent from hitting the field. And continues to be a serious problem. Oh, that high explosive barrage. What is he doing? Get out of there! That was painful to watch. How many kills does this have? Four? Really? It looked like a lot more than that, I guess. I guess not. Only 5 of 15 Folks Grenadiers remain. That looks like a lot more than 4 corpses to me. I can count, right? I guess they died to small arms fire. Apparently there's an Ostwind over here. Interesting choice. I guess he feels that he has more than enough anti-tank in the form of two elephants, and then Ostwind will help supplement his anti-infantry. He has almost no infantry of his own left. Only one machine gun in one pack, no grenadiers, and one squad of pyos. Looking pretty thin, which would probably explain why he hasn't really been able to get much territory back under control. He's doing a good job of managing the T-34s, obviously, since if they expose themselves for even slightly too long, they'll just get blasted by elephants, but at the same time, without any infantry, you can't take territory. At least, not in very many places at once. Panzer IV and Ostwind leading infantry as they advance quite nicely, and the Stuka sounds like it's continuing to wreak havoc in the Soviet base. Not sure if that really hit anything, though. But it's got 27 kills after not that many barrages, so yeah, it's definitely doing quite well. How many is that now? 4? Something like that. This elephant's now vet 1 and is making its way towards the river. This one continues to defend the cutoff, and not sure what YG now is thinking of getting next. He's got 290 fuel in the bank. He could get himself a King Tiger if he wanted to. His biggest issue seems to be manpower. Mother Russia being activated. He's getting charged right on his battle group headquarters. But fortunately, the Ostwind is nicely placed to shut down his push. If these two tanks had not been present, he could have potentially lost a lot of infantry right there. Another Ostwind is in production, but he's so pop-capped he can't even field it. Tofu is really applying a lot of pressure here, but at the same time, it's a little bit unhelpful. He's clearly probing for weaknesses, trying to put pressure on the cutoff, trying to put pressure on the base. Both of those things certainly helpful, but the bulk of Axis forces are here on the left side, and it's all Kawagizi can do just to even try and take their own munitions on their half of the river. Not to mention the ever-present threat of these two tanks. Ostrin goes down to the KV-1 and field gun. Panzer IV is soon to follow. Lots of AT weaponry and T-34s is way too much sustained damage, and both of those tanks will go down. He quickly fields a replacement. He's got money for another Panzer IV as well. He can just continue to replace those losses as long as he trades nicely, but he's really not. He's just kind of losing units for no reason. Over here on the left side, the Command Panther is now Vet 2, doing a little bit of light harassment, trying to vet up his Oversoldaten as well. And the snipers are still alive at 45, or no, wait, one of them died. Okay, one's got 45 kills. I don't know how much the other one had when it went down. This one's now up to 6, it's a fresh sniper. T-34-85 destroyed. On the one hand, I am curious if this Oversoldaten could have been prevented from hitting the field, but on the other hand, I wonder how much this squad has cost him in reinforcements. Those snipers have probably been bleeding him like crazy. I honestly wonder if they've even been cost effective. They have 20 kills, but those snipers are brutal. Brutal manpower bleed. It's probably a delicate balancing act.
The enemy has 300 points remaining.
Yet another Ostwind getting a little bit too bold. The Soviet AT guns are quite well placed, and without infantry to flank them, the Axis are kind of struggling a little bit over there on the right side, just losing tanks left and right, kind of faltering a little bit here in the late game, which shows no sign of ending, by the way. As usual, crossing in the woods, turning into a brutal slugfest. His Stuka has 42 kills? That has been an incredibly powerful Stuka. And it has decrewed slash destroyed no end of AT weaponry. Now that both of those are decrewed, he is going in hard with this Panther. He is out for those snipers' blood. But they will retreat to safety. I'm not sure if he's going to go in on that SU-85. It's firing quite fast. Higher rate of fire makes it very deadly, but it's going to disengage because there are two Panzer Strikes on the way, and a King Tiger has just been fielded, making its way towards the left side as well.
Gun mounted. Ready!
King Tiger is making its way forward, and hopefully it will succeed against those snipers where the Panther did not. There's not much over here that could threaten it except for that vetted SU-85, which will chip away at it slowly but surely. It needs to be careful with that. Sending it in unsupported will be dangerous as a result. It probably wants to try and field all of his forces simultaneously, with King Tiger leading the charge, hopefully fully repaired, and he may experience more success on a second push. Meanwhile, here on the right, it doesn't really look like anything's changed. The elephants continue to simply defend. Can't be very aggressive with these units, and tying up 50 of your pop cap in two elephants means that you pretty much lose any ability to be the aggressor. So he's kind of relying on his teammate a little bit to push into territory. The Mother Russia gets utilized again. Very nearly losing him, that Folks Grenadier squad. More Stuka rockets being fired. It's now up to 50 kills. Almost Vet 3. You don't see that very frequently either. Repairs are about to complete on the Vet 2 Panther, but it looks like he doesn't want to wait any longer and is pushing ahead with his King Tiger. He does get the munitions over here on the left back under his control. We've also got Panzer Grenadiers making a push for the center victory point, but they're getting shut down by that stolen machine gun yet again. And there's actually three squads of Panzer Grenadiers on the... Well, there were. Now there are two. Now one died. The Bundle Grenade very nearly took out that stolen machine gun, however. And the armored push across the left side is going well. This elephant should easily be able to scare away that SU-85. Huge damage with his first shot. Sea grenade penetrates the King Tiger's frontal armor and it will suffer engine damage and now needs to pull back to safety. Another Panzer Grenadier squad just got wiped somewhere. He is taking heavy losses. YG now has no means of repairing this other than his mechanized regiment HQ, so he definitely needs to get those Sturm Pioneers, or a fresh squad of Sturm Pioneers, on the field as soon as possible. He has the pop cap and manpower for it. Simply choosing not to purchase them, so I guess he would rather just use the mechanized regiment headquarters to repair, but it's going to be slow, and it's going to be... He's not going to be able to repair any more position. Stuka dive bomb getting called in. It's been a while since we saw one of those. It will completely destroy that machine gun crew. And a plane just landed on that tank almost, I guess. I guess it was a little off target, fortunately. I think it might have also just killed this entire AT gun. There we have it, every single cast this game. A plane crash kills, or every single cast today, or tonight, or this morning, or whatever. A plane crash has killed something. Target down. 56 kills on that Stuka now, wow. If only they could make a Berg Tiger and resurrect these poor tanks.
Grenadiers back to full strength.
Panzer Grenadiers getting shot over there on the right side. T-34-85s. Wait, what happened there? Apparently there's some dead combat engineers in the Soviet base. I don't even know how they died.
Taking effective fire!
apparently reconstructed his tier 4 structure here to defend the left side purely as a defensive position. Might succeed. There's no B4, there's no field guns left. Any field guns that get produced will get shut down by the Stuka. Definitely a good way to shut down enemy infantry, but at the same time he has no way to repair it, so he should probably field some Sturm Pioneers. This King Tiger has been fully repaired and is pushing its way up the left side. Has elephant support this time, so it appears no SU-85. Grenades going off over here. Victory points are draining. Elephant nails the SU-85. King Tiger does the same. It's one shot bounces on the King Tiger's rear armor. I'm surprised that King Tiger just doesn't drive straight in and seal the deal. He may be slightly afraid of these AT guns, but it looks like they're not gonna last. Oh, wow. I think that was the Stuka's incendiary barrage. I've never seen that ability before. That is the very first time I've ever seen that. That was pretty cool. Wow, that seems really strong. And as we all know, it does share, or it does not share the cooldown of the standard ability, which is probably why it's at 4 and so incredibly rare. Seems pretty strong. That is a huge spread of flames. Panzer Grenadiers take heavy damage and will be forced to retreat, but they do clear out that AT gun will be recruited. Stuka is firing its standard barrage now. Clearing out an AT gun and nearly destroying this SU-85. King Tiger's taking heavy damage from that SU-85 and needs to pull back for repairs again. Still no Sturm Pioneers on the field. 74 kills on that Stuka, holy shit. Hit anything too bad. Wow, if he had placed that Stuka dive bomb right here on the Soviet base, that could have been really nasty. Stuka fires its incendiary barrage here, including Maxim. And not much else. You might want to be kind of careful how he uses that ability. Although it doesn't share the cooldown, it does cost 100 munitions, so it's not exactly in a position to just be firing that every time it's off cooldown. Although he does have 48 coming in, which is a lot. Especially as OKW, their munitions control this entire game has just been so strong. Shortly after hitting the field, apparently this one's fresh, so his vetted SCG squad that he had for a while is dead. Those two snipers look like they're still going strong. I'm pretty sure one of these has survived from the beginning of the game and now has 61 kills. The one that he had to replace is back up to 23. So I'm pretty sure he's gotten almost, 150 kills with snipers? Or 140? 130? A very large number of kills with snipers. He's actually outpacing this Stuka with his snipers. amazingly. Whoa, there are two T-34s in the Osterre base. An elephant is being mobilized to respond. It looks like a Panzerfaust maybe, or a mine. I'm not sure what happened to engine. Give that one engine damage, but that engine damage will be crucial in taking out that tank. The other one will get away alive. Meanwhile, here in the center, a squad of guards is dangerously close to being wiped on retreat. And there it goes. Folks Grenadiers will take control of the victory point despite taking fire from a mortar. More squad wipes, more Stuka barrages. The carnage just never ends. I've never seen kill counts go so high. This is almost going into the three digits. Looking at the victory points, it might before this game is over. Oh geez, retreat. I think everybody's mental endurance is starting to run a little low. Getting harder and harder to respond to threats, to remain focused.
You are showing weakness. We are down to 75 points.
Company of Heroes is an extremely mentally taxing game. I'm getting exhausted just watching this game happen. Wait, the Stuka died? How did the Stuka die? I totally missed that happening. Did that happen on screen and I like wasn't even paying attention? I don't even know where it happened. Okay, Stuka's dead, apparently. According to chat, I don't even know what happened. Oh, the SU killed it, okay. How did I miss that? Seems like an oddly first usage of infiltration grenades. I think that is the first time this entire game he's used that. Surprisingly. First time I've seen it anyway. 58 minutes into the game, he places his hand. T-34 is making a suicidal charge into two elephants! Oh no! Oh, that one just got blasted. AT gun trying to support here. This one has no chance of making a successful flank. P-4 will finish that off. Elephants firing on this one. The shot misses and it will try to retreat to safety, but those two T-34s just got taken out in the EHA. Did almost nothing for them. King Tiger's been repaired. The repairs from this OKW player are so agonizingly slow without Sturm Pioneers. I really feel like if he had just made some Sturm Pioneers and kept up the aggression with this thing, he probably could have ended the game 20 minutes ago. But I don't think it's gonna matter. The victory points are finally ticking down, putting this game to a sweet and merciful end. And there it is. GG, well played. Almost a solid hour into the game. And that's it. The Axis won thanks to the glory of Jaeger Armor Doctrine. Wow, look at all this float. So much float. 850 fuel. from all sides. After a certain point, the game becomes all about manpower and really nothing else. And your commander, obviously. Unless you're OKW, in which case you can make King Tigers and Stukas and stuff. Well, that's gonna be it. Thank you for watching the video. That was a hell of a match, and I am exhausted just having watched it. So, GG.